Speaking here with Rajesh Latchoo, coach at Joe Public, TTFF instructor, heavily involved with the sea license course that has been taking place under the Dutch influence. Rajesh, tell us a bit as to how, you know, at the ending of last season, you were put at the helm of the Joe Public team and you all finished on a high. And now looking ahead to the 2011 season, what can we expect from Joe Public?
I think this year, the players, they prove that despite being youngs and despite having no big names, that they are big names within their own right. And they are deserving of the opportunities. Like, for example, some of our players have been called up to the national team. They have worked hard towards the opportunity. And we look forward to getting the other players ready so that they could get the opportunity also.
The likes of Andre, Tuse, etc., can we expect him to be part of the Republic setup for the season?
Yes, most definitely. I think his experience and his knowledge is invaluable towards the team and the other players.
You think to some extent he has filled the shoes left by the departure of Caribbees in terms of the goal scoring department?
I think he has filled the shoes. Again, each player is unique. When Kerry would be Kerry, Tuse would be Tuse, and offer different aspects. As long as the team gets goals and Andre continues to score, he's doing what he's been paid for.
Anything new that we can expect from Joe Public in terms of your approach for the season? Are you all going to emphasize and stick with the youth development and try to get players that have come through the system at Joe Public? Or can we expect a couple of new signings for the season?
I think that the team would have youths as just as we finish. Maybe they might have one or two new signings. As time goes by, we would know for sure. But at the end of the day, the team would be focused on developing the youths as much as possible.
You in particular, your role within the TTFF coaching system now, how has that been for you?
I think it has been very, very valuable. It was a great experience. I keep learning every day. Every day I meet with the other instructors. I learn from them. I learn from even the participants new things every single day while we teach. You know, it's a two-way learning process. And the knowledge that I have gained has helped me with regards to preparing the team, especially in the upcoming season and dealing with them in the ending of last season.
What made you really want to get involved in coaching at this level? I mean, you know, you've come from a background where, you know, a lot of people say it would be difficult for coaches to come out from that area in particular. Tell us a bit about that.
I think to me, it was faith and God, because it started when I finished school. I had the option of doing engineering or getting into sports. And in my school, we weren't the best. We were known as football school.
What school was this?
College, Princeton. You know, so, but I was heavily involved in the sports. And then I saw through some teachers different avenues that would open up in the future in the sport. That's the avenues that presently I'm engaged in. And it was there that I had to make a decision, because I was to go UTT and UE, do mechanical engineering or the MET. And it had one day I had to tell my father, look, I want to go down the sports road. That was the most worrying day of my life, you know, because he had expectations and he accepted it and he supported me in it. And a matter of fact, I set out to do sports kinesiology or even sports psychology, Dr. Rudy Weber. You know, I used to be thinking one day I'll take a job with the West Indies team, you know, as one of the sports psychologists back then. And what took place is my dad presented to me, look, you were doing the art and science of coaching. Because I was holding off, they were supposed to start the sports kinesiology program within a couple of years. And he said, well, look, if you want to do this for the meantime, and I'll help you with your prerequisites. And I got involved in it. I was already coaching in St. Stephen's and in the Princeton TTFF had a development clinic that was running at that point in time. So these things, it went into each other. And as it went, like I told you, I think it's fate. God channeled me in certain directions that eventually took me to where I am now.
All right, great. Thanks a lot and good luck in your endeavors.
Thanks.